I think the way the debate has developed during those years is a key factor, that it has become more radicalized. The media, the politicians have also become more radicalized, which means it's even harder to get through with a message of nuances or with a message of we need to look at this with a more open mind than the eye for an eye rhetoric. How you looked at, if you're one of these young guys or girls, then it's very important how you're looked at. And with the debate that is going on in Denmark right now, they are only looked at as a problem. And that's not only regarding jihadism or radicalization, it's in general. Yeah. They are, from the starting point, a problem. And if you're taught that from you're very small, that you are not part of the society, but you are a problem in the society, and what are we going to do with you? If that's the approach that you meet, I think there's a bigger risk that you become hostile towards that society.
Parents and children, they have to speak together and talk about this issue and say, why are you looking this one, and why are you going this friends, why are you going this places, why are you hanging this bad friends or something like that. So the parents, they have to be also know it, where the children going outside, who they hanging out with them, and that's also very important for you to talk about.
But in order to do that, I think it's important that the films don't stay in the nice art house theaters or in the nice universities or in these more cultural circuits. It's very important that the films get out there where the young people are, where they live, where they have their everyday life, where they have their discussions and their experiences with racism or with whatever. What drives one to actually go and blow himself up and the other one to stay at home? There's a very thin line, I think, sometimes. Mm-hmm. And that's also worth remembering when we talk about preventing radicalization or doing the de-radicalization, that the line can sometimes be blurry and very thin. Mm. And it still, I think, depends on what kind of, you know, relationships do you have with other people. Is somebody listening to you? Is there somebody that you can identify with? You call it a role model, but yeah. Is there somebody that you actually want to listen to that feels relevant to you when you're a young person of 18 or 19 years old? That is very important. How can we convince them that society, the democratic society, is valid for them? If we say that, but the rules doesn't count for you, you have to, you know, you did something wrong, now you can rot in hell. I mean, we're undermining the very principles that we are claiming to fight for.
And it's easier to say, like, this is problem about immigrants, it's problem about Somalia, but these young people, they grew up in the Western country, and they grew up our society, so, and they're going our school, and they're going our education system, and maybe also works system also. So you cannot just throw out and say, we don't need you like that because you are garbage, something like that. But for me, it's like, even they're making bad decision, like every young people make it, you have to make empathy, you have to show them, and they always get second chance in this society.